Welcome back to Kung Fu Maintenance. Well, recently installed a reverse osmosis system and definitely made a lot of mistakes going through it as I did it. You know, thought I'd share them with you up front so you would not make the same mistakes. As, you know, if you can learn from my mistakes, then hopefully you don't have to make your own. One of them was not inserting the tubes far enough, pushing them in far enough before inserting the locking clips. Another one is making sure that nothing is going to hit like a pull-out faucet. If you're pulling it up, making sure that the lines, when you run your lines, that they're not crossing that pull-out faucet so that nothing's going to get moved around. And another was if you, any spot where you use Teflon tape and you turn it in, you never want to back it up. You don't want to turn it back out. Like if you're adjusting a tank or something, it's better to kind of complete another turn. If you back it out, especially with plastic parts, it can take that Teflon tape off, and then you may wind up having to redo the whole thing like I did a couple times on this one. One other thing is once you get everything set and done, it's probably a good idea to mount it, add some screws where the main filter housing is so that things don't get bumped around or moved and then cause a leak. So a good idea to secure it. I didn't show that in the video, but I just wanted you to know that, you know, there's two little screw spots for the main housing. So adding those screws can keep from it being moved around. That way you don't develop a leak. Anyway, let's jump right in on how to install the reverse osmosis system. It's a really cool system for cleaning and purifying your water. And if you want to make it even better, use the alkaline filter. It helps bring the pH of the water to an alkaline state, which if you can get your body to more of an alkaline state, it's much healthier. You know, you might do some research on alkaline water online. There's a lot done on that study. But anyway, here it is. Thanks for watching.
So one of the first concerns is placement, figuring out. I'm actually probably going to be mounting it to this side wall here, though. The thing is, that's not a very strong material. And the other side's probably no good. But you can see it's so thin. Ay, ay, ay. And the other option is just kind of setting it on the ground and loosely mounting it. I think it kind of makes most sense up against this side in that it'll be easier to get to. Either side can really work. Good to verify I have no leaks to start with. It's our cold water line. Kind of strange. Actually, I'm wrong. That's our hot water line. It's going to the dishwasher. Hot water on the left. What I was saying was strange is the cold is usually on the right. So here's our cold water line on the right. These shutoff valves work different. This is for mobile. And coming up here, I've got a splitter and then I hooked up a faucet outside some time ago. So going to have to probably add my deal right there. Right in between here. It's gonna be fun. It's like a half inch connection to a half inch connection. So not too bad. And then we'll be connecting to the drain. That's not too bad either. I don't have a whole lot of room, but we'll manage. No biggie. Okay. Might go into this part of the drain. Kind of don't like the idea of being too close to the disposal, where if something clogged and then the pressure of the disposal, you know, I want to make sure it's not getting in the drinking water. All right. Still haven't made the video showing you guys the hose installation, and maybe eventually get around to that.
Welcome back to Kung Fu Maintenance. Today we're doing the unboxing on, all of a sudden I forgot what it's called, water purifier, reverse osmosis. a nice filtration system. It has a lot of different options for it. One option is alkalinity, where it changes the alkalinity of the water, and that has some health benefits. Filters. This is the max water flow reverse osmosis water system. So instructions taped on the inside. That's good. Membrane element. And here's our main deal. And the hub, the whole deal. All of our tubing and a drain connection. Here's our spout. Okay. And in the tank. Little storage tank, reverse osmosis water storage tank. Okay, just gonna wrap two or three turns of Teflon tape around the threads, and want to make sure that you're going clockwise or going with your threads the way your deal will be screwed on. And it's only two or three turns, so. Two and three quarters. There we go. And these are a plastic threading, so you pretty much only get one shot. And you want to make sure none of your Teflon tape is covering your hole. That's an obvious deal, but it does happen. And this we don't want to over tighten. Just going to put it on nice and tight. Just finger tight. Okay. Okay. Gonna operate everything. There we go. Okay, and this cap deal that it comes with works as a nice little stand for the tank. So you can position it. So that's a cool deal. Okay. Now getting into the... Just gonna go ahead and pre-wrap this one. Okay, so figured I'd go ahead and pre-wrap this one since I got the Teflon tape out and ready. That's the other thing we're gonna go with, the threads. I'm just gonna go two or three turns. Three quarters. Okay. Now that's ready for the install. PAC cartridge. This one's actually the middle one. Okay. This wrench here. Looks like we're tight there. All right. Deal came apart on me. There we go. Okay, first stage is, the third stage is a 1 micron sediment filter, and the first one is a 5 micron sediment filter. Okay, so this one's the 5 micron, and it goes towards the feed, the cold water supply, so that's going to be this one here.
These are lubricated with a tiny bit of petroleum jelly. Just gotta make sure the deal's in line there. And then we've got a wrench. And last but least is our 1 micron sediment filter. So the first one filters out a lot more stuff. And here it is, the 1 micron filtration. So. Go. Stubborn. There we go. All of our wheels are on nice and tight. Okay, there we go. Now we're ready to install our membrane filter. The reverse osmosis membrane. Okay, here it is. Going this one here. Easiest way to do this one is going to be to remove the C-clip here. Just by grabbing the back of it here, pull it on down, don't want to lose it, and then we can push our tube part in and then pull it out. Okay, now we can unscrew this much easier, that way we don't mess up our tape on there, and then now is our membrane. Okay, and these go inside. You take a peek down there, it just feeds straight on in, and then seat it in all the way. There we go, and now we can reinsert our cap deal. A little more this way and reinsert our deal all the way, and then we've got our C-clip.
Just got to pick it up enough to get it underneath. That just clips right in place. Real simple. Nice and easy. All right. Okay, next this came with our elbows here. Now these have already been pre-coated with Teflon tape. And then we've got all our C-clips for hooking up the water lines. So, just start by inserting these or inlet and outlet deal. Just make sure they're not cross-threaded. And we're going to seat it all the way to the O-ring. Pliers, I just lightly turn it in, aim it up. There we go, seat it right to the O-ring. Good there. And same with the other side. O-ring, and we're good there. And these actually call for hand tightening normally, so probably should have just done it by hand, but I really only used it to turn it a little easier. So anyway, on this side the red hose gets inserted down and in, and I want to insert it as straight as possible. All the way in, and then we're going to use one of the C-clips and lock it in. So, push it on in right here, it'll kind of pick it up a little bit, and lock it in just like that. I think I actually need to go to the side. Way all the blue is under the white, just like that. Okay. On the opposite end, got our line to drain and our water line in. Okay. Don't fall, buddy. Okay, so now this line's going to go to the faucet. This line's going to go to the drain, and this is going to be our feed or our in supply of water. Definitely some different considerations in putting it under the sink. We want to be able to reset the garbage disposal if needed. We want to be able to take apart the trap if needed. We want to be able to shut off the water if needed. So I think I might put this on this side and put the tank on this side just to make sure I have enough room. You know, I still got a ton of cleaning chemicals and everything that normally get stored down here, so it's going to be a little tricky, but I think if I put this on the other side, that should work a little bit better. Okay, so the kit called for an 11 millimeter drill bit, but I actually don't have an 11 millimeter drill bit. What I've got is a little 3/8 inch. It's a tiny hair small, so just going to kind of have to work with it a little bit. No big deal. Mark where I want my hole and drill it. We'll make it work. Of course, making sure we're not going to hit anything below that we don't want to hit. And it's all fun and games to puncture something you weren't supposed to. But here we go.
drill bit's running out of juice. There we go. Okay. Now we can test it out. And I'm pretty sure I'm going to need to widen it a little bit, but we'll see. Yep, for sure. Hopefully my drill bit hangs on here. Almost there. That should do it. Yay! Alright. And now we need our little kit here. It's got a lock ring washer, a couple other deals going on. Little gasket. Okay. Put this through here. It's probably going to be easier to take this blue film off now. Just in theory. Okay, and then we've got a locking ring. I believe this just goes up like so. The lock ring most likely goes underneath. So this would go here, just like so. And then underneath the sink, we've got our locking ring and that. So this can sit nice and flush, just like that. And underneath the sink, we'll get the locking ring and nut. And then we've got the ferrule for the tubing. And little inserts. Okay. So here we go. We need to kind of hold it from the top and get it from the bottom. And tank a little bit away, so pull the tank back out for now. And we need a locking ring. Okay, we're finger tight. We're good there for now. I can tighten it with the wrench a little bit later, just kind of get things situated here. Okay. Seems a little odd, but go from there. Okay.
Well, we've got our drain. And the drain, I really want it on this portion here, about 2 inches above the trap at least. And so I think it'll make better sense up here. If the sink ever backed up or the disposal got a little funky, don't want it too close to the disposal. This has a few nuts and we just need to separate at least one side. And then we can just kind of turn the other side through. There we go. And we'll put it facing us so we can see anything that's going on if anything ever happens. The nut there. Oh gosh. Things have a way of traveling. There it is. Okay. We'll lift this up, install it where we want it. I don't want to go right on the imprinted letters of the deals that might mess it up. Okay, just start to loosely tighten this down. Okay, and again, just not on the letters. Be able to use a screwdriver to tighten that down. And then I've got a 3/16 inch drill bit. And we'll drill right through. Again, I'm avoiding getting right on the letters. My little 3/16 inch drill bit, it'll fit right through. My drill is out of juice. Just enough to do that. And now I gotta charge it. You never want to run a drill too low. It'll kill it. It'll kill the battery. So now I can tighten down the deal all the way. I was gonna slip it up and make the drill bit to 1/4 inch instead. I think I'll still do that. And then what I'll do is I'll use this drill bit to feel through and make sure that we're in where we want. So that's why I didn't tighten this down too much. Now we're gonna loosen it. Slide it down and expose my hole. And then I'm gonna use a 1/4 inch drill bit. Just make that a tiny hair bigger. Okay. Again, now it's time to charge that drill for sure. Okay, so back to my old drill bit. We're gonna slide it up, make sure it's positioned, and then run the back of it straight through, and we're good there. And now we can tighten down our screws, set our drain in place. And we don't need to over-tighten this. Just snug is good. We're good there. Okay. Now we're going to be able to hook up our water supply. So that's the next step. So we're going to turn off the water here. Now this one, this is the cold water side on the right side.
And with these, what you got to do to turn it off is hold one side and then pull it up. This is a little bit different type of shutoff than your traditional shutoff. So just want to support the pipe. Pull it up. There it is. And we'll verify that our cold water is turned off. Okay, good. All right, and then now I've got to disconnect the supply. It's right up top right here. This one, I've got a special setup, so it's going to be a little trickier than normal. And it's probably a good idea to put a little bucket or something down to get some water. It's going to keep out there. Rather hold that deal. I need something to catch the water. Plastic bowl. Yep. There we go. Pull back in. You know how to redo it. Might be better to redo it as I've already jacked out the Teflon tape, so. First, but that's okay. Okay. Mostly in the bowl, so that's good. And our nipple will pull back out. And I'll redo my Teflon tape. And we've already got Teflon tape on our connector, so I'm just going to give a few turns on this other deal. Okay, so we got the nipple all set up here. And now we've got our supply. And I've got my choice here on whether to, I think I'm going to insert the nipple first. So I'm going to connect this in, turn it turn it all the way in. And make this side nice and tight. Just hand tight. And then we'll turn this in here. Make sure it's not cross-threaded. Good there, and now we'll connect our water supply back on to our new connection. Okay, there's our water supply. Same thing, want to make sure we don't get it cross-threaded. It's plastic, so pretty much only get one shot. And we're just going hand tighten. Okay, now we're ready to run our lines. So we've got our color-coded deal, but it really didn't have any directions on how the color-coded deal should go. But I'm going to go with yellow from the water supply. And I'm going to kind of pull the deal out so I can hook it up. So it should be a little bit easier to have a little bit more room. But we're going to go yellow from our water supply. And I'm also going to run my lines where it makes the most sense. So I'm going to be putting this one behind the plumbing here. And then this one will go up to our water supply. We want a shutoff ball valve right there as well. And it may actually put that shutoff a little, yeah, we'll put it up there. Here's the shutoff, so we're just going to need to cut our yellow line a little bit. Got a nice strong pair of scissors. Just gonna cut a small section. One we can insert our deal in, and then we've got those little blue clips. And I'll insert that right there. Okay. Light turned off. Oh, jeez. The phone got a little wet, so not liking me at the moment. There we go. Add beer. Okay, so this one we're gonna connect up. Well, in this end, we're gonna use another connector. And connect this end. Okay. And then we'll face this towards us. Insert our connector here. And put our blue clip on. And this will be a good point to leak test everything. There we go. Clipped in. Good there. Now we can shut our ball valve off. And in theory, we can leak test everything. And what I'll do is I'll run my tube into the drain here just to make sure. Little deal here. Just in case. Move my bucket. Right here. And we'll test it out. Okay. So I'm going to open the cold water side. Whoop, 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 whoop. That's not good. Haha. Leaked from right there. Okay. So, is what it is. It leaked from our connection. Looks like from the back of this one right here. So I need to redo that. Pull the little clip off. And push our deal in and pull it out. Take a look. Everything looks okay there. Try to reinsert. I'm gonna reclip that and we'll try again. Okay. I'm gonna cut it here. Reclip it. As soon as I find my cutters. Wish I had some stronger cutters, but I don't. So. Is what it is. And this is my problem. It's, got the wrong tool. Ay, ay, ay. I do not have a different pair of these. Oh my gosh. I'm trying to make this look good. At least better. Okay. Try again. Insert it all the way in. And put our clip in. Okay. Here goes the test. All right. No leak, that's good. Our ball valve is working. Test our sink and let the air out of the line. Good, good, good. Okay, on to the next phase, which is leak testing here a little bit better. My camera's going crazy because I got water on the screen. There we go. Okay, so field test here and all these points, make sure we have nothing funky going on, and we don't, so we're good there. So now I can move this around, and now our water is back on, and I can get this around where I wanted it, which is back here. Okay, examine our connection there, looks good. Okay, and now that's going to be our in to our deal right here. Got another blue connector here. Okay, and this is our in to our system right here. Insert that all the way and use our little lock-in connection here. And sometimes you got to pick this up a little bit in there. There we go. Okay, next we're going to go out to the tank and then we've got to the faucet. Okay, so to the tank I'm going to use blue and the tank I'm going to need to put in a little different than I thought. Whew. All right. What are you gonna do? Alright. And then the last one's gonna be up to the faucet where I'm gonna use the blue one. The little clip deal, insert the blue hose, reinsert the clip here, there we go, and now we can, I can put the unit back inside. And the blue hose is going to go up to our faucet. So, kind of keeping everything behind here so it doesn't get tangled up with anything else. All right. And now we're ready for that to go up to the faucet. Got the ferrule and then the little ferrule nut. So first it's going to go, the deal gets slipped on here. No, first it's the nut. And then the little washer. And then this goes to the bottom of the connector.
that up and in. Slide the nut up. Nice and hand tight. Okay, and now for the tank. Tank first connection is going to be on this side. All the way back here. Pull our little blue clip. Okay, and I'm actually going to bring the tubing wire back around and behind the deal just so it's out of the way. Everything else. And now we can insert it all the way. And use our clip. Lock it in. Okay. This one we'll move back here. Okay. And now is the tank connection, which we're going to need to aim towards the back. I can always get more tubing and turn it around if you want to later, but it's not really critical. Definitely gonna have some cleanup to do after this is done. But here's our tank. And bring our deal back around. Insert our tube on in. And then we need a little clip. And then we've got one more deal to the drain, which is our red hose. Well, there's the clip. Okay, we're in there. Okay, now it's for our red drain hose. Somehow I forgot about it. Okay, here's our drain line to the front. That part's easy enough. Okay, all set up there. Now we gotta run this one around to the deal itself, which means I might need to maneuver a few things here in order to get it in, because it's actually hidden back there a bit. I should have done that one first. But hindsight's always 20/20.
And I think they did not give me enough clips. Motors. That one's in all the way, but I need one more clip. I've got it. I'm gonna search the box. There's that one. It was very tricky. Very, very tricky. Still is tricky. All right. Well, I'm missing one little clip, so I'm gonna have to take one. I think this place is gonna be from the drain line, and then I'll just make something to work for that one. I want to have this one where it's kind of hidden back here, unclipped. So this one is so difficult to get to right there. I don't want that one without it. So now why they couldn't extend that out, and also why they couldn't include extra little, you know, one extra clip wouldn't hurt. But there it is. Okay. But I think that probably the drain line one, I need to reclip all this back together because I had to kind of move it out to make room. Okay. You know, one extra little clip wouldn't hurt. Right here. That's that. I don't really need all this extra tubing from the drain line, but so I need to manufacture something just to hold that in there a little bit better. But my cutter is not very good, so I don't want to cut it because I won't be able to get such a clean cut. So anyway, I just need to find a paper clip or something, or a C-clip that I can use for that front deal. Okay, so I didn't have a deal for that, but what I found is I have a little split ring washer, so I'm just gonna try to bend that a little bit and use that instead of the clip. Let's see if I have any luck here. Some manufacturer little clip. Don't try this at home. Might not work. I believe the little slide just will just a hair bigger. Good work. We'll see. Here it goes. Right. Hopefully not too strong. Oh my gosh. Well, it's on there holding it out, so it's that. I was hoping it'd kind of clip on. There it is. That's good. Okay, now we're ready to test it. Here goes. Yeah, open the ball valve and let it run. There it goes. Uh-oh, I got water. Okay. Question is where we're shooting water from. Oh. Looks like our yellow hose right here. Probably where I got those kind of four cuts. And turn the water on briefly and then turn it back off. Yep, right there. Okay. So I just gotta rework that. Pull the clip. And these you just push the inner portion in, pull the upper portion out. There we go. So examine our end. It looks really clean. Looks like a good cut. I'm just gonna try reinserting it. Push it in all the way. So maybe it just wasn't inserted far enough. I did not want to insert. This one's fighting me all the way. I do that sometimes. Don't give up. Don't let it matter too much. It happens to everybody. Okay. There we go. Now we're inserted all the way. And now, got our cool clip, if I can grab it. Definitely got plenty of cleanup after this is all done. Can't all be easy. Sometimes what's worthwhile isn't so easy. There we go. In now. I'll test it again. Time will tell. Here it goes. You ready? I'm ready. Hey! Okay. Push it on back where it's gonna stay. And now our filtration is all filling up. Test everything for leaks. You'll want to check with your insurance. Something like this can actually void your home insurance, so you have to check if it's okay for you. We're going into the drain line now. Tank is filling. Better check that tank deal. Oop. We need this open. There we go. It's open now. Okay. Gonna start filling the tank. And we need this to run for about 2 hours. I hate to waste water, but at least I'm on a septic system, so it's all going to the yard. Oh, but that's what it takes to clean it, purify it. So come back in about 2 hours and check it. Okay, got everything running. Got our tank line open. Got everything open here. No leaks. All right. Double check my tank. Okay. Good, good, good. Yep, I can clean everything up. All that's gone. Okay, it developed a little leak from the front, so you need to turn it off. And gonna reset that and try again. That's not good. Okay, I pulled it out and reset it. It seems like it just wasn't inserted enough, so here goes turning it back on and retest. Good, no more leak. It's definitely just gonna take some testing and monitoring. A good idea is one of those little leak monitors I showed in a different video where it senses water and it'll sound an alarm. You know, these push together fittings and stuff, they are kind of, you know, they can give, and they can give in the middle of the night, and that is not a good situation. So anyway, I kind of needed a little bit of water to clean things up, which I was cleaning up when it happened, so kind of a good thing. Looks like that came loose too. Oh man. The valve itself is leaking. Jeez. All right. I'm just gonna go without the valve because the valve is leaking from the handle right there. It's not the fitting. It's not this fitting spraying up. It's actually the valve itself. Piece of junk. Not coming from up higher. Alright. Use the whole deal to control it. You can always get another little valve. Just gonna double check this one. That's good. And double check all these. Those are good. Double check everything here. That's all good. Double check everything here. That's good, that's good. That's not good. I see a little water right there. It's okay now. Sure is temperamental. Haven't even tried the faucet yet. Let's try it. Not even working. Probably because the tank's not full yet. Sounds like it let some air in from the faucet tube. It could be air in the lines until... There it goes. So it's still just taking a while to fill. So that's good. Just kind of wanted to know. Yeah, we're leaking from here too. Man. This one's just giving me all kinds of grief. Hey, but if I get rid of that, I'll have my clips that I need that I can use for here instead of the metal clip. So that's good. All right, so I'll go ahead and get rid of that valve. Before I get rid of anything, I'll need to turn off the tank now. There we go. Now I can disconnect it. Yeah, it's leaking right from the ball valve. Can't all be easy. But this is getting ridiculous. Push it in, pull it back out. glad I turned off the tank. Okay, and then this one, pull this one out. At least I'll recover the correct clips. So there's that. And it's funny, my original instinct was not to hook up this ball valve. Definitely got some pressure there, holding it back. Oh, there it is, it's gone. Okay. Now with this one, we're just gonna go straight in. Push it all the way in. Pull our deal out a little bit.
Okay.
Now I've got that one on, just need the blue clip. There's the clip. And now right here we can replace this with the proper clip instead of this deal. Okay. I'm gonna pull it and reinsert it. There we go. All right. Now reinsert it all the way. Yeah. Important to get those inserted all the way. Okay, now the proper clip's on there. Now I'm ready to turn the water back on. And here goes. Here's hoping. Okay, no leak here. Oop, I need my tank open. Tank's back open. That's good there. Now everything sounds good. Sitting right on the dishwasher cord, and same with the red hose. Okay. Well, now I can finish cleaning up and just monitor the situation, make sure nothing else goes funky. It's gonna need to run for a couple hours. So, that's that. Big mistake I did is running the blue hose right through where the pull-out faucet. Hose is going to pull it every time, and we really don't want that, so we need to redo that. No big deal, but it must be done.
Yep, and you might have noticed earlier in the video that it was leaking from the tank. I wound up having to shut everything down, turn it all off, and redo the Teflon tape to the tank shutoff valve. Yep. Just checking through everything. Finally got it all worked out, but definitely made a lot of mistakes on the road. One of them was making sure that there's no moving parts that are going to move across your hoses. Another one was back turning anything that had Teflon tape on it. You just want to turn it in. You never want to loosen it or turn it the other way. And then inserting the hoses all the way. Those things were critical to make everything work out here. But really cool system. It's alkaline. It makes the water alkaline, which has a lot of health benefits. It purifies the water. It's, you know, the reverse osmosis. So definitely it's a six-stage filter. So a lot of filtration going on, filtering things out, making the water cleaner and healthier to drink. So pretty cool. There's a lot of studies on the alkalinity. You might research a bit about alkaline water because it has a lot of benefits if you can get your body more alkaline, pH balanced. So here it is, everything working. Another mistake I had made is you don't necessarily want to open the tank first. You want to leave the tank closed, run the system for 2 hours to drain, and then open the tank so that you're filling the tank now with water, that the filter has gotten rid of all the extra particles on the filter rather than that going into your tank. You know, hindsight's always 20/20. You learn a lot from your mistakes. I hope you learn a lot from my mistakes so you don't have to make the same mistakes. I'll also try to put the mistakes in the beginning of the video so that you can get an idea ahead of time. And anyway, thanks for watching Kung Fu Maintenance. Over and out. This, with this system, I was able to get rid of a bottled water system. Kind of cool. But it may be a good idea to save some reserves of water in case of anything. You know, I live in California, which is earthquake country. The truth is, there's no guarantees about anything. Our water supply, our electricity, all these things, our food supply. We can't be trusting the government or anybody else really to be taking care of us in the event of if something bad happened. You know, we all kind of need to take some steps to preserve things for our families and ourselves and our, you know, even our neighbors, that we can help each other if something goes wrong. I think it's something we need to get back to in America. And anyway, thank you for watching Kung Fu Maintenance. Over and out. Sending home.